To me, it's kind of weird that we're already coming up on the 1 month mark of World War II. It seems like just yesterday we were all hyping each other up for the launch and getting excited for what we hoped for was probably going to be a better launch than what actually turned out to be, but nonetheless, it's already been almost that full month's time. So that said, we're getting now to the point in time in which we can start to question not only for the fact of fixing bugs and everything like that and some of the issues still facing the game, but also we can start to think about some of the updates to the game coming and what else that can bring for us as a consumer, as a player. And one thing that has definitely sparked the interest of an update coming is the announcement of the Winter Siege event for World War II, in which we're gonna have a lot of cool stuff, and we're gonna talk about that a little bit here with this one. But also, on top of the stuff that's been announced publicly, there's a lot to cover in which hasn't been covered publicly. So in this one today, we're gonna be talking about the massive Call of Duty World War II update, what you can expect in it, and when it may be coming, when you can expect to maybe prep yourself for a download or just to be able to jump right into the action. Now, full disclosure, a lot of this stuff is still, once again, under wraps and in the game code, not necessarily publicly out there, so I can't show anything on screen for you guys for reference as either B-roll footage or just reference at all, but I can leave some links down there in the description below if you guys want to check it out for yourselves. Whether or not those links will still be up by the time you view the video, that is, of course, entirely up to chance and just how hard the enforcement team is coming down on those that are posting the actual footage of all this stuff. But that said, let's jump into it. So firstly, we know that the Winter Siege event was detailed as per the Sledgehammer blog post a couple of days ago, in which they talk about the game update that as of this going live today was a week back now at this point, where Double XP was launched. We got some information on ranked play, we got some information on Winter Carrington, and some game updates coming in the next few days as of this happening and then further in the future. Now, detailed publicly to us was Winter Carrington, and which actually will be free to everyone for the duration of the event, which is definitely awesome. And if you guys don't have the season pass, you don't have Carrington for yourself, you can end up jumping in and playing a little bit for however long you want during this span of the game. It'll be free to you entirely. And then also the headquarters is mentioned as being something that is going to be set in a snowy theme. And of course we have the detail and data mine footage of different supply drops for the winter drops specifically. So there's a lot of cool stuff there within what's been mentioned for the Winter Siege event, which starts on December 8th, and it's not just for a few days. It's gonna be stuff where incrementally we'll see stuff roll out to us across the rest of the month of December and then a little bit into the new year. As well, we have to bear in mind that a lot of these changes that have been detailed for game mechanics and everything like that, specifically like Global Flinch, that sort of stuff is coming as well with the Winter Siege update too. So there's a lot of stuff on all fronts that we've been publicly showcased already. But where we start to get into stuff that is not detailed on the surface by Sledgehammer officially, this is where we start to break into a ton of stuff regarding weaponry and game modes, because these are two heavy hitters in which players are most likely going to be interested in, because of course, new weaponry, it's a lot of stuff to play around with, new toys if you want to put it that way in the Christmas spirit, and new modes also allow players to experience the game in a little bit of a manner they haven't already. So as for the weapons, we talked about this in a video a week or two back now at this point, in which the full list that was leaked out to us, which it may very well be a preliminary list, we may have some more added in as time goes by and as the year progresses on, because there are a decent handful of these weapons already detailed, but whether or not they last the entirety of the year and the content season, that's something that we don't know exactly. But the full list includes the Gewehr 43 or the Euro 43, the Type 5, the Volkssturm Gewehr, the Beretta 38, the Sten, the Beretta 30, the M1919, the MG81, the Arisaka, the Winchester 94 lever action, the Enfield No. 2, the Walther P38 pistol, the Reichsverwaffe revolver pistol, the ice pick, the combat knife, and the trench knife. And all of these have variants, by the way, keep that in mind. So they're not just the base weapons alone. They're all gonna have epic and heroic variants as well too. But what we talked about in that video detailing these a little bit earlier was that a lot of these weapons didn't have animation. So therefore they didn't really point towards being ready in a standard fashion coming up. Those that did have animations were the Gewehr 43, the Beretta 30, and the Reichs revolver. Thus leading in my mind to be those forefront ones leading the pack and being the ones first released to the public. But as of the recent update, there actually is an update to the amount of weapons that have animations. So we do have the Gewehr 43, the Beretta 30, and the Reichs revolver, but we also have the Sten, the Volkssturm Gewehr, the Beretta 38, and the Walther P38. So there has been some progression with these. Now, of course, I still think I'm going to stick with my guns and say those first three, the Gewehr 43, the Beretta 30, and the Rex Revolver, are the first ones up, but we definitely have some more progress than we previously thought. So whether more of these get released at one point in time, or whether or not more just get pushed closer to the release of the first set of these, we don't know, but it's just interesting to see that a lot of these have had progression already made, and maybe this big patch coming up will only further that idea that more will be ready on the horizon. But that said, jumping over to another big topic out of this, and one that we'll definitely see, I think, directly affected by this large patch coming up in the near future, are the game modes. Now, we touched on briefly that there's a couple of things underneath what the public already knows about, and that is actually five modes in particular. Gun Game, Lockdown, Demolition, Infected, and Control. Now, Gun Game is exactly what we know of, and it's actually something that still has some files in the public build of the game. If you go to, I think, your challenges, your combat record, you can see that there's Gun Game stats there, but Gun Game isn't actually in the game. And apparently there's actually been recently glitched lobbies where people get into Gun Game. I actually had my friend Diablo tweet me a couple of times about this, in which he got into one or two games where he was searching for a TDM lobby and it just threw him into a Gun Game lobby. And it wasn't photoshopped or anything like that, it's actual footage of it, and it's, to me, just further proof that not only is it coming, but it's coming soon because it's already in the game. Now, moving on though, Lockdown is like Domination, except where it differs is that you need to stay on the flag or close to the flag to earn points. So if you leave it, it's a neutral flag, but if you're in a certain vicinity, you control that flag and then you end up getting points for your team. So it's kind of like a stationary but multiple hardpoint sort of game mode, if you ask me. Now, Demolition as well, we mentioned, that's your standard Demolition. Same with Infected, same thing as we've seen previously, but of course, no exosuits, so it's beautiful, back to classic Infected. And the final one being a mode called Control, in which it's essentially the old school war from World at War. Not the war that we know of now, but the tug of war game mode that we had in World at War that was a classic and then was momentum in Advanced Warfare. Now, of course, also on top of all this kind of stuff, we have Season 1 of Ranked Play starting this Friday, but let's talk about the juicy stuff, what we all really want to know. When will this be coming, and what realistically will be a part of this update? And if you pay attention to different dates thrown about the community and different tweets and different blog posts and different things like that from official sources, there's two dates now that are prominent within the upcoming future: Friday, December 1st and Friday, December 8th. Now, Friday, December 1st is the start of Ranked Play Season 1. So maybe it's Friday the 1st, but maybe it's Friday the 8th, which is also the start of the Winter Siege event. Now, this is actually when I would expect to see this coming for a number of reasons. Gondry has addressed December 8th as a key date on a number of occasions and outlined it in the blog post as well too, but with December 1st, that date is perhaps just a hot fix to unlock Season 1. It throws off some of the expectations being a second date on everybody's mind, but I don't think that we're gonna get an actual dedicated patch. Maybe just a hot fix to once again unlock Season 1. As well, when you think about all that is already publicly detailed, aside from the weapons and the modes that we just talked about and such, as in the headquarters and a free map that is themed appropriately, that being Winter Carrington, that sort of stuff takes a physical game and title update. Whereas, say, playlist updates can fix, say, double XP, game mode settings, and in that case, Season 1 of Ranked Play being unlocked. And other minuscule stuff like that, that's all attainable via hotfixes and playlist updates, but full-fledged additions require a dedicated update and a patch. So that means that, along with a themed map, the headquarters, and other seasonal decor, the rest of what we've mentioned already could be slipped in under the radar, though probably not because we'll have an understanding of what kind of content we'll be getting via update file size, but the sentiment still holds true there. Now, how I'd expect this content to be released is via various different incremental rollouts, especially for the game modes. Now, while we detailed that Gun Game, Lockdown, Demolition, Infected, and Control are currently in the game code, they probably won't come all at once, and maybe not even all of them will be coming. We'll talk about that one in a second, but I would more so expect them to be added in a similar fashion to Weekend Warfare from Modern Warfare Remastered as well. If we were to drop them all at once, it would significantly stagnate the player population in the other modes, so releasing them all at once probably wouldn't be a good idea. So incrementally, maybe say one per weekend, that would perhaps be ideal then, so that they all get worked in the rotation, and then moving forward, perhaps some get added in as permanent, but maybe some being once again like a Weekend Warfare type of deal. It really doesn't matter, but I would expect them more so to be incrementally rolled out. But there also is that possibility that we don't get all of them immediately. Now, while they are all in the game code, we also have to realize that some of them may not be finished. as we've seen with various assets for weapons and all that kind of stuff, just because they're in the game code, they may not be far enough through development to be actually released, but they are enough in development to have their footprint in that game code that allow data miners to be able to check them out and everything like how we get them now. Now, while I'm not saying some specifically won't come, in some in-game footage for, say, Lockdown, there's a little bit of a flag glitch in which it seemingly was spazzing out between friendly and enemy control way faster than that of if somebody was stepping on and off it, perhaps as a result of maybe coding error or something similar. And also in Control, the war substitute from World at War, the icon for the capture location on the minimap is the standard default texture missing icon, identical to that of the Global Thermonuclear War or the 11th Prestige emblem from Modern Warfare 2 that a lot of people may recognize immediately. So while they're in progress, we might not see all of these modes coming. Now, as for weaponry-wise, I'd expect some drop at some point in time during the Winter Siege event. That's because it falls perfectly in line with what we've seen previously in the release calendar for Call of Duty content. The earliest that we've seen previously weapons drop was in Black Ops 3, in which we got variants of the melees in mid-December, a month or so, give or take a few days after launch, and Winter Siege is set up to be following these footsteps. And while we might not get weapons directly on the 8th, we may get them in a different time throughout, fitting once again that calendar of release. We also mentioned that more weapons have been completed for animations and menu information, but that still doesn't really take away from my initial thoughts that we'll be getting the original Gewehr 43, the Beretta 30, and the Rex Revolver, the ones that were the furthest in development as of the last update and patch that we got last week. Now, I'd also expect them to be done nearly identical to the Infinite Warfare and Modern Warfare Remastered system, where the base weapons for players are free either via Siege event, Season Pass, or via challenges, and then have variants in collection and in drops, potentially in their own timed collection, like how we saw in Modern Warfare Remastered, there was the Shamrock and Awe specific drops and other things along those lines. So while it comes down to two specific dates, either this Friday or next Friday for things to launch, I'm thinking more so towards next Friday. Maybe the patch comes out at some point in time during this next upcoming week, and then it goes live for everybody next Friday, or perhaps we're just completely wrong. We don't know exactly, but it's something that I'm more so once again leaning towards that later date of December 8th. And for this Winter Siege event, it just makes so much sense to me. So that said, that's where we're gonna wrap it up. There's a lot of stuff that we talked about here within this one. So love to get your thoughts and feedback down there in the comment section down below. What are you guys looking forward to? Are you looking forward to Winter Carrington? Are you looking forward to a headquarters with snow and all sorts of other decor for the holiday season? Maybe, just maybe, you end up having a populated headquarters to share that also with. Hopefully that's the case, but I guess we'll see. Or are you guys more so excited for some of the stuff we haven't had detailed publicly to us, like some game modes, some weapons, or anything like that? Feel free to let me know down there in the comment section down below. But hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, and if you guys did, make sure to drop a like down below. And of course, if you guys aren't new to the channel, make sure you guys subscribe to stay up to date with everything we have here regarding Call of Duty World War II. We're gonna keep you guys up to date with everything you need to know regarding news, updates, patch notes, leaks, tips, tricks, best class setups, all that good stuff. We got you covered here up on the channel, so if any of it interests you, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a single thing. And finally, if you guys want to follow me over on Twitter, that's the best place to get connected with me outside of YouTube, but practically live on Twitter. So if you guys want to strike up a conversation, ask me a question, whatever it may be, link is down there in the description below. But all that said, now that we hope you guys have a fantastic day, thanks so much for watching. Mine has been Espresso. I'll see you guys later. Take care and peace.